Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting again. Oh yeah, we're painting again, and this time we're gonna have a go at a portrait. Yes, a portrait. So I'm gonna use a bit of yellow ochre, a bit of this red. It's like a crimson colour, making like a orangey colour, and I'll use this to get the portrait started actually. Oh no, my page has got red on it. Oh well. It won't matter too much because we can paint over it. So I'm going to paint in the shape of this person's head. I got this picture off Earth's World, which is earthsworld.com, which is a website that has a lot of people sketching reference on it. It's really good actually. So I'm going to block in the basic shape of the person using this colour. Just think about the skull, really. Think about the shape of the head and the anatomy where the nose is, where the eyes are. And then where the beard is, because this guy's got a beard. So I think we're about close. We're pretty close. I think we are. So something I want to get better at is portraits. So I'm going to do a few. And then I'll try to get better. And then the mouth's about there, I think. Looks a bit weird, doesn't it? Just gonna paint in like a hole. Oops. It's got some brown. It's very watery though. Got some brown and blue. For the hair. So the hair. About there, I think. We'll build this up as the painting progresses. Thinking about the underneath. If you've gone life drawing and you found that challenging like I did, then you know what this is like. It's a challenge. But it's good to have challenges in painting. You want to be able to challenge yourself, try to get better. That's why I am always thinking like that, trying to get better. Put a little bit of white in the colour, a little bit of white for this area. It's quite a grey beard. I think this guy dyes his hair. This is good practice for painting a Gandalf. Cracking beard though. So actually, I think I've done the head. If that was correct, the beard would be right down here. So I've got some stuff wrong. Oops. Something like that. Anyway, we'll just see what happens as we paint it. I think that head goes further back like that. Try and get that shape there. Something like that. Now what I can do, I can get a bit more of a crimson, blue and yellow and white. Show you the colour I'm making. It's not quite red enough. Some white in it. And a nice reddish yellow ochre. Nice yellow ochre and pink. I want it to be quite reddish though. And that's looking quite good. A bit more white in it. Try this colour. I'll throw more red in it. A bit more red and a bit more yellow ochre in it. Yeah. So I'll chucked a bit more red and a bit more yellow ochre in there. I might even go a little bit more red. That, to me, might work better, I'm not sure. We shall try and build this up. It's not bad, actually. Some on the nose. Might get a little bit more yellow ochre. More of the yellow ochre in the colour. The area for the eye, which has got quite a bit of darkness in it. Can throw a bit of this, bit more red on my brush, get some of this underside of the nose. And this sort of darker colour there. Sorry about the reflection. When it dries, the reflection will vanish. It's just the, unfortunately, the nature of watercolours. You can see there what it looks a bit like. And we get a little bit more I'm going to throw in some white into this colour mix that I used earlier, and I'll throw in some more yellow ochre. And that's nice. That's quite a nice colour. I can see the top of the head has a bit more of this sort of colour in it. Use my finger just to melt it together a bit along there. Bit of light on the nose, on the cheek. On the eye. Around there. A bit more light there. And the tip of the nose. I'm going to re-highlight that afterwards. I just wanted a bit more light on the nose there. Just use my finger to tap it. Wherever you want to see brush strokes, that's all right. Wherever you don't, then you can tap them away. It's up to you. That's not a good thing about painting. That's something you can do with oil paints as well. It's not just something with this. See, I kind of think of painting as just painting now. I don't think of it like I can only use one medium. A few like marks and shapes in there. More light there as well, not part of them, in between the eyes. So we need another brush. Oh, the brush missing. Oh no, there it is. So I only use a few brushes. That was the half inch graduate brush I was using, and then this one, the Cotman number 668. Just use a few brushes. You don't need these sets where they sell about 50 brushes in a set. You just don't need them. I know that because I've been one of those people that have bought a load of brushes and then you end up using two or three. You just need brush, a biggish brush, a smallish brush, a middle-sized brush. You don't need loads, do you? So we've got to think of where the eyes are. The eyes. We've got a nice dark area. One of the eyes finishes about there. Or I should say starts. I think it's like that. It's further back than that. Finishes. Oh, I've gone to the wrong part. It's further back than where that is. Oh well, let's move it. More like there. Got that area a bit darker, strong red in there, and then we've got the other eye. there. I might need to use this brush as well. Got a few brushes going on. My goodness, a round brush as well. I need one for light, one for dark. Don't want too many. So I've got a darky, sort of a purpley colour. I might go for a bit more red. Sort of a reddish purpley colour. For under here. Dark there under the eye. Might use a bit of this dark in the nostril as well. And, okay, now we can go here and go. Got an eyebrow to put in as well. And that part of the eye. A little bit darker. Get that part of the eye as well. That cheek. Having a look at that, see if I'm getting closer. I am painting a little bit on off the cuff, as they say. Not too bad though, it's not too bad so far. I'm not panicking yet. The other day I was doing a portrait and I messed it up at the end, so the video never got made because I started to kind of panic. I was like, it's not working. I changed a bit and then changed another bit. Before you know it, I bodged it up. It's easy. Easy done. I want a bit more yellow ochre. I think sometimes I think I could be magic with my brush and just suddenly get it right, but it didn't work out that way. I'll get a bit more colour in this area. And that shape right, that head. a little bit of light there as well. Okay. Okay, that's a bit better. I need to put some eyebrows in. Put eyebrows about there. And here. And this eye on the other side should be lower. I think it should be more like there. Too bad. A bit more dark in there, in that nose, in there. Area. Bit of light. Don't want it to be quite as light as that. Yeah, that eyebrow should be a lot lower. So let's get rid of that. This bit of the eye done. It's kind of important to get the eyes as close as you can. It really is. Because it tends to be the hardest bit. There is a tiny bit of light in the eye. Sort of there. moved the picture by accident. I'm going to go a little bit lighter now with my colour. Got a little bit more white in it. Still in the same mix, the yellow ochre and the red. Okay, a bit of light on that head there. Bit of light there and here. Something like that. Just get a little bit more dark just to get rid of some of that in there. Yeah, it's better. And some reddish bluey colour with some lines on the forehead as well. Put them in and then kind of soften them again. I think that's a bit too high, that one. And a little bit of colour. The outside. Oh, I've got his hair as well. Some hair. Some bluey brown. Let's darken that a bit. Oh, how did I get red in my colour? That's a bit better, a bit more blue. Actually, I don't mind that red, that dark. Few hairs on the top as well. Not too many. Bit more of the browns. And on this side here. Like that with a beard. I can use that hair actually to round up the nose. To show the eye on the other side. That's not too bad. I still need more light, but I'm going to do the beard next. Just going to grab some white in the blue and brown. Just a bit of white in the blue and brown. Might get a little bit more brown. We'll start with that. I'll go on my brush a little bit. It's about there, I think. A little bit of a skin colour for the neck that you can just about see. Sort of a bluey colour. aqua, bluey grey. There's clothing. Got a bit of shadow on it from him. From his head. It's not dark enough. And then something like that. Something there. Got his other arm. I mean his other arm, his arm, not his other one. One of them, his hand's like there, it's holding him. But you can't really see that much, so. And then I want to do a bit more lighter colour on his beard. Use this brush. All these different wiggles of hair. It's quite good fun doing portraits, isn't it? They're a bit hard, but they're still fun. I enjoy it anyway. I enjoy it. Just it's fun as it progresses. It's fun to see. I'm gonna put some little sort of greyish blue highlights in his hair. I'm just thinking that the hair would have a bit more blue in it from above. That's the reason I've done that. The white in the colour. Maybe get a bit of Naples yellow as well. I'm going to get this shape there. Something like that. That warmth, and then that warmth here as well. I'm tempted just to show that these are eyes, to put a bit of light in them. I wonder what it'll look like. Kind of works, actually. I need to also bring his hair across his face a bit, because it is a little bit too wig-like. Something like that. I do quite like this, actually. Going to do, I think, I'm going to get rid of some of this here, so I'm going to put a bit of this bluey red here. some of this, a bit of white, a bit of red. Go into my other brush actually, so I don't want to ruin the head bit. Something like that. Yeah, and I think I'll call this one finished. Tempted to have a bit of a burnt sienna colour. Just in that part of the beard there. As well. Yeah, and I think I'll call this one finished. I've had fun doing this one. And start thinking about my next one. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it gave you a bit of an idea of what you could do. And I'm going to put in a little bit of area for where the mouth is there. Somewhere around there, and you got some white to go over the top of it. So there we go. Thanks very much for watching this episode. And hopefully I can do another portrait very soon. So I'll see you at another one. Cheers. Bye.